My next guest you may have seen on Fox's Open House or on her very own HBO special, and you may have seen her receive the Comedian of the Year Award on the American Comedy Awards. Say hello to Ellen DeGeneres, ladies and gentlemen. Hello.
Hey, Paul.
How are you? Nice to see you.
Just sit it down.
Right here, Mr. Beaudry. There you go. Boy, I'll tell you, Larry's career has really slipped.
Yeah. Is that Larry?
A few snacks?
Well, you know, yeah, there's food back there, so, you know, I'm going to take that home.
You didn't want to leave it behind.
Yeah, that looks good. There's
We do. We serve all sorts of stuff to the guests. Look,
put that down. That's mine.
Zingers. No. No.
Do you want some? I'll give you some. Hey, back off. Give you some a little later. So, hi.
Hi, nice
How are
to
you?
See you.
Mm. I've just been drinking lots of caffeine back there.
You need to, because you're basically a pretty laid-back person.
Am I?
Yeah, more so than most comedians.
I guess I am. I guess I am a laid-back comedian in a different type of a comedian way, not typical to the most comedians.
And so what do you think made you decide to become a comedian?
Well, I don't think that's any of your business, but I think
Thanks
that probably...
I'm just going to have a snack then, I suppose.
Good, that's why I brought those. I don't know. I mean, I guess probably because... one of these. Probably because my dad was always playing practical jokes on me all the time.
And, so your whole family's kind of funny.
Well, my dad was. He was always doing... Like, I remember one time so vividly, I was 7 years old. And seven. And I was in the backyard playing. It was a real hot, sunny day. And I ran into the kitchen to pour a glass of lemonade because I used to just love lemonade when I was a little girl. I still drink it. I don't drink it as much as I did when I was a little girl because I drink it all day long. Sometimes I drink too much. I'd get a little tummy ache. I'd be laying in bed at night going, Mom, I got a tummy ache. But anyway, so I went into the kitchen to pour a glass of lemonade, and I loved it. And so, and in the kitchen was my dad and my mom and all my brothers and sisters standing there staring at me, about to start laughing, you know, and I was like, what, you know, because I was seven. And my dad said to me, he said, Ellen, honey, you were adopted and we've never liked you, so we've sold you to a tribe of Iroquois Indians. We're going to go to a movie. We'll be back a little later. So bye-bye. Good luck. And
he's a funny guy.
Yeah. So anyway, I lived in the Eurydice Mountains for about 9 years with the Iroquois. And learning basket weaving and pottery making, and I taught him that noise you make under the arm like that, because that was the skill that I had. And it was customary to marry within the tribe at 13 and have several papooses, which I did. Anyway, 9 years later, here comes trudging up the mountains, my dad, my mom, all my brothers and sisters, carrying a big thing of lemonade, going, we're just kidding, we love you, you're ours, come on home. And so we went home and laughed. And but you know what? The funniest thing is they weren't even real Indians. They were actors my dad hired to play Indians to fool me, you know,
because
I'll still see him today on an old run of like a Mannix or a movie of the week with McLean Stevenson. And I'll go, oh, hey, there's Running Steve, you know. And so it's fun to see him again sometimes like that and remember my childhood. But that's why I'm a comedian.
I see.
Hey. Candy for you. Thank you.
Who loves your baby?
I'm going to do that, too.
What else would you be doing if you weren't doing stand-up? Apparently not a dietitian. You wouldn't be a dietitian.
Really? Is this not good? Can you still understand me if I would talk like that?
Yeah, I can, yeah, sure.
Okay.
Well, I speak in the same language.
Pretend like you're a dentist, and then you would actually... This is preparation to become a dentist. You have to listen to people talk like this and figure out what they're saying. They didn't understand that. I don't know what I'd be doing. I have no idea. I may be a perfume lady, like, you know, those people that spray perfume on you.
People in the stores?
In the stores, just because that, you know, how hard can that be to get, you know, you just, they hand you like an aerosol thing and they test you for a minute. Can you do that? Mm-hmm. And then I don't know why that job was ever created. You know these people when you walk into a department store and they just come right at you with that product, like... I don't want it. I mean, they don't do that with nose spray. Nose spray? You know, you're... No! You know, just... You know, deodorant? Douche? Hey! You know, but...
I would imagine that would be a lot more training for that particular one.
Not necessarily.
Well, where are you heading career-wise? What do you have coming up?
I don't know.
Is it, now you brought a guitar with you. Is this something new you're doing
in
your
life? Oh, God, I'm so embarrassed. I wrote a song just for you, for this show.
Yeah. Candy and a song.
And, well...
Candy and a song. Next you're gonna ask me to get in the van again.
Can you? I wrote a song just for you for this show, and when I was driving over here, the music flew out the window, and so I don't remember it. And, it was really good, too. It was, you know, like, it was like, let me see if I can... I don't play guitar, but I was using it for, like, a drum thing. I can't remember. It was something. It was like a, it was like PAUL PROVENZA. I like him more than a Mercedes Benz.
I like that already.
Do you? It was really good. So it was good lyrics. I mean, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch helped me write it. And they're
so
excellent.
Those are basically all the lyrics
are so good. Marky Mark is, you know, Donnie D's on the backup, drug free, so put the crack up. That's really good. That's good. And so he helped me write it, and it was good.
I had no idea that you were a musician.
Well, that's what I was going to be, actually. That's so funny. That's the only other thing, because I was in a band when I was younger, and they asked me to play keyboards in it, and...
What was the name of the band?
It was Satan's Tongue or something like that. And we played, like, it was misleading, because we played Carpenter tunes and things like that. But so that held us back with a lot of work. But I don't know why we named it that.
Ellen DeGeneres, folks. You gotta go. Come on back.